Veronica Taylor is a voice actor best known for the role of Ash Ketchum, or should I say the original Ash Ketchum. Veronica Taylor was recruited by 4Kids and was then cast in Pokemon as the main character, Ash Ketchum, of course. She continued voicing Ash until 2006, but we will explain why she only lasted until 2006 in a little bit. She also provided the voice of May from 2003 to 2006 and many other reoccurring characters during her time with the franchise. 2006 was the time when 4Kids lost rights to the show and Pokemon USA decided to replace Veronica Taylor and other members of the original cast. Because of the Pokemon franchise increasing popularity in the US, the international Pokemon distributor Pokemon USA began looking for ways to cut costs on production of the English anime, and decided to find a new partnering company who could produce the English version cheaper. Once 4Kids' contract expired in 2006, they were outbid by TAJ Productions, who had earlier helped 4Kids in their production of the English language version of the series. However, according to statements made by Veronica Taylor and Eric Stewart, who voiced Brock, the voice actors were to be replaced with different sound-alike voice actors to keep production costs low. TPCI has not made any official statements on those claims. The episode the new actors started were in the special The Mastermind of the Mirage Pokemon, or what I like to call it, the episode that started my anger with the anime. Because of the voice changes, Kids WB did not renew their contract with the series, so Cartoon Network picked up the show where it is still currently airing. Pokemon lost its prime 9 o'clock central time slot, and the show's ratings and views started to go down. I could take a few guesses why. Veronica Taylor was replaced by Sarah Natocheni, who took over the role of Ash Ketchum and Delilah Ketchum, and Michelle Knotts, who took over the role of May. During this time, Veronica was emotional because she lost not only a role, but a character who was very dear to her heart. This was Taylor's message about this issue. Unfortunately, this is very real. We have been informed that Pokemon USA has already made plans to do the anniversary special with substitute voices. Apparently, they have not made a firm decision on the next season yet. None of us have been formally asked to do the show, we've simply been told we'll be replaced. Pokemon USA has made no effort to negotiate with 4Kids, simply feeling that getting a cheaper rate to dub the show is enough. They care nothing for the quality. They will be using new script writers, voices, music, etc. We, the voice actors and those at 4Kids who work so hard on the show, are all extremely upset as we care very much for Pokemon and what we've worked to create. However, there is nothing that we can do. It seems that the only resource is for fans to write to Pokemon USA and tell them how wrong their decision is and how it will adversely affect the show. Thanks for your concern. Please spread the word and let's all try to work together to right this wrong before it's too late. For those of you younger viewers who don't even know who I'm talking about, now you can understand how devastated we were when we heard your current Ash voice for the very first time. There was even an online petition to bring Veronica Taylor and all the other voice actors back because of how raged pretty much the entire Pokemon anime fan base was. There were still actually so many upset fans from hearing Ash's new voice in Pokemon The Mastermind of the Mirage Pokemon, there was a recast to voice his role. Unfortunately, it wasn't Veronica Taylor returning, but the current Ash voice, Sarah Natocheni. Her voice was better than Casey Rogers in Mastermind of the Mirage Pokemon, but Veronica Taylor's Ash Ketchum is irreplaceable. We may be used to her voicing Ash, but to this day, there is still controversy and unease with how Pokemon decided to change the voices just to save money. I know I will never forgive Pokemon for that. TAJ Productions, the company that took the rights from 4Kids, went out of business in early 2008 and DoArt Film and Video became Pokemon USA, which is now called the Pokemon Company International's new partner in producing the English dub. Due to Pokemon's already huge popularity, the production of Pokemon weren't kept as low. Due to that, DoArt brought back many of the original voice actors to play newer, smaller roles, and Ted Lewis was brought back to continue playing his roles, most notably Giovanni. Others were brought back, but none of the main cast, which makes me wonder why to this day. The show, already being a kid-friendly from 5 to 12 years old, took a slow turn with the new voice personalities to viewers closer to the ages of 5 to 7. Not sure if this is due to the writers or the voice actors, but the show now has a completely different vibe to when the anime came out in 1997 to how it is now in 2015. We can only hope for Pokemon to revert back to how it was in the beginning, but we all know it will never feel like that until the original voices come back. There is a petition that is still going on, and I will put the link in the description of this video so you guys can like, support, and share the page. It's called Save Our Voice Actors, and their mission statement is on point. You guys can read what it says on their page. I would like to do my part and start the hashtag VeronicaTaylorForXY, and I'd love to have your guys' support and start this trend and see where it goes. It's never too late to go and fix a mistake. Here's a sample of the main characters voiced by different actors in the anime.
We're stuck now.
And now that the sun's gone down, it's getting pretty cold too.
Yeah, and I don't see the Pokemon Center on the PokéNav.
Those clouds are looking mean. We'd better find some shelter and fast before the storm's on top of us.
Huh? Pika? What? Hey, what's up, Pikachu?
Pika Pika! Huh? Pikachu!
Wait, Pikachu, come back here! Where are you going?
Well, Dr. Young, it's been a long time.
It's nice to meet you. I'm Ash.
Pika Pikachu!
Hi, I'm Misty.
Hi, I'm May.
My name's Max.
I'm Brock. Nice to meet you.
May and Max's father is the gym leader in Petalburg City.
I bet you guys want to become gym leaders too.
I don't know about that.
I don't even have my first Pokemon yet.
Well, that's it for this episode. So if you guys want to see more episodes like this, leave a like. And if you haven't subbed yet, go for it and sub, because we have a lot more content just like this. Here are my other episodes with the same style of video like this one you just watched. See you guys for the next main series video, but until then, I'm out. Veronica Taylor is a voice actor best known for the role of Ash Ketchum, or should I say the original Ash Ketchum. Veronica Taylor was recruited by 4Kids and was then cast in Pokemon as the main character, Ash Ketchum, of course. She continued voicing Ash until 2006, but we will explain why she only lasts until 2006 in a little bit. She also provided the voice of May from 2003 to 2006 and many other reoccurring characters during her time with the franchise. 2006 was the time when 4Kids lost rights to the show and Pokemon USA decided to replace Veronica Taylor and other members of the original cast. Because of the Pokemon franchise increasing popularity in the US, the international Pokemon distributor Pokemon USA began looking for ways to cut costs on production of the English anime, and decided to find a new partnering company who could produce the English version cheaper. Once 4Kids' contract expired in 2006, they were outbid by TAJ Productions, who had earlier helped 4Kids in their production of the English language, not made a firm decision on the next season yet. None of us have been formally asked to do the show, we've simply been told we'll be replaced. Pokemon USA has made no effort to negotiate with 4Kids, simply feeling that getting a cheaper rate to dub the show is enough. They care nothing for the quality. They will be using new script writers, voices, music, etc. We, the voice actors and those at 4Kids who work so hard on the show, are all extremely upset as we care very much for Pokemon and what we've worked to create. However, there is nothing that we can do. It seems that the only resource is for fans to write to Pokemon USA and tell them how wrong their decision is and how it will adversely affect the show. Thanks for your concern. Please spread the word and let's all try to work together to right this wrong before it's too late. For those of you younger viewers who don't even know who I'm talking about, now you can understand how devastated we were when we heard your current Ash voice for the very first time. There was even an online petition to bring Veronica Taylor and all the other voice actors back because of how raged pretty much the entire Pokemon anime fan base was. They were still actually already being a kid-friendly from 5 to 12 years old, took a slow turn with the new voice personalities to viewers closer to the ages of 5 to 7. Not sure if this is due to the writers or the voice actors, but the show now has a completely different vibe to when the anime came out in 1997 to how it is now in 2015. We can only hope for Pokemon to revert back to how it was in the beginning, but we all know it will never feel like that until the original voices come back. There is a petition that is still going on, and I will put the link in the description of this video so you guys can like, support, and share the page. It's called Save Our Voice Actors, and their mission statement is on point. You guys can read what it says on their page. I would like to do my part and start the hashtag VeronicaTaylorForXY, and I'd love to have your guys' support and start this trend and see where it goes. It's never too late to go and fix a mistake. Here's a sample of the main characters voiced by different actors in the anime.
We're stuck now.
And now that the sun's gone down, it's getting pretty cold too.
Yeah, and I don't see the Pokemon Center on the PokéNav.
Those clouds are looking mean. We'd better find some shelter and fast before
version of the series. However, according to statements made by Veronica Taylor and Eric Stewart, who voiced Brock, the voice actors were to be replaced with different sound-alike voice actors to keep production costs low. TPCI has not made any official statements on those claims. The episode the new actors started were in the special The Mastermind of the Mirage Pokemon, or what I like to call it, the episode that started my anger with the anime. Because of the voice changes, Kids WB did not renew their contract with the series, so Cartoon Network picked up the show where it is still currently airing. Pokemon lost its prime 9 o'clock central time slot, and the show's ratings and views started to go down. I could take a few guesses why. Veronica Taylor was replaced by Sarah Natocheni, who took over the role of Ash Ketchum and Delilah Ketchum, and Michelle Knotts, who took over the role of May. During this time, Veronica was emotional because she lost not only a role, but a character who was very dear to her heart. This was Taylor's message about this issue. Unfortunately, this is very real. We have been informed that Pokemon USA has already made plans to do the anniversary special with substitute voices. Apparently, they have not so many upset fans from hearing Ash's new voice in Pokemon The Mastermind of the Mirage Pokemon. There was a recast to voice his role. Unfortunately, it wasn't Veronica Taylor returning, but the current Ash voice, Sarah Natocheni. Her voice was better than Casey Rogers in Mastermind of the Mirage Pokemon, but Veronica Taylor's Ash Ketchum is irreplaceable. We may be used to her voicing Ash, but to this day, there is still controversy and unease with how Pokemon decided to change the voices just to save money. I know I will never forgive Pokemon for that. TAJ Productions, the company that took the rights from 4Kids, went out of business in early 2008, and Do Art Film and Video became Pokemon USA, which is now called the Pokemon Company International's new partner in producing the English dub. Due to Pokemon's already huge popularity, the production of Pokemon weren't kept as low. Due to that, Do Art brought back many of the original voice actors to play newer, smaller roles, and Ted Lewis was brought back to continue playing his roles, most notably Giovanni. Others were brought back, but none of the main cast, which makes me wonder why to this day. The show